JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for May the 15th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded lower or unchanged against the other G10 currencies on Thursday during the Asian morning Friday. It gained only against the Japanese yen, while it underperformed versus NOK, the Canadian dollar, the Aussie, SEK, and slightly against the Kiwi. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the euro, the pound, and the Swiss franc. Now, the weakening of the yen and the strengthening of the Aussie suggest a risk-on trading environment. Although major EU indices were a sea of red yesterday, the US ones traded in green waters, with the rebound in investors' morale rolling somewhat into the Asian session today. Japan's Nikkei 225 and China's Shanghai Composite gained 0.53 and 0.17% respectively. Now, although there was no clear catalyst behind the improvement in risk appetite, it seems that lately there is a battle between those who are afraid that easing the restrictions too soon will result in another wave of exponential spreading of the coronavirus, and those who believe that the peak is behind us and that economies around the globe have entered the road to recovery. During the EU session, the first group had the upper hand, with the driver perhaps still being Fed Chair Powell's remarks over an extended period of weak growth and stagnant income, as well as remarks by US President Donald Trump, who blamed China over the coronavirus outbreak and said that the pandemic is casting clouds over the future of a trade deal between the world's two largest economies. Later in the day, it seems that the second group saw the slide as a good opportunity to jump in, pushing US equities higher despite another jump in initial jobless claims for last week. As for today, investors may turn their attention to the US retail sales for April. Expectations are for headline sales to have tumbled 12% month over month after sliding 8.4% in March, while the core rate is forecast to have declined to minus 8.6% month over month from minus 4.2%. A soft report would mean that demand softened even further during April, with consumers still refraining from spending. And more importantly, it may be a sign that the US economy entered the second quarter of the year on a weaker footing than it ended the first quarter. Thus, this may serve another round of risk aversion, perhaps pushing equities back down and safe havens back up. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European morning, we get Germany's preliminary GDP for the first quarter and the second estimate of GDP for the Eurozone as a whole. Germany's economic activity is expected to have contracted 2.1% after stagnating in the fourth quarter of 2019, while for the bloc as a whole, the second estimate is forecast to confirm that the euro area economy shrank 3.8% after expanding only 0.1% in the fourth quarter. In the US, apart from the retail sales, industrial production for April is also due to be released, as well as the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for May. Industrial production is anticipated to have fallen 11.5% month over month after declining 5.4% in March, while the University of Michigan index is expected to have slid to 68.5 from 71.8. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.